Ryan, ready. Ready. Go.
Let's see what the pretty boy Kwon Won-il from Korea brings to Manila tonight. Aaron Kelly ground the balls of his feet, thrusting the jabs early, Dragon.
He's got to slow down the movement of Kwon Won-il. Kwon Won-il is coming off a nasty heel hook submission.
Oh, he got it!
Look at that straight right hand. The right hand does it again. And then Wreck-It Ralph all over the place. Dropping the hammer fist. Sleeping Kelly in the first. And then the Wreck-It Ralph starts to thunder down on Kelly.
One.
19 seconds. One of the fastest finishers in history. It's time for Cosmo Alessandro of Brazil to ramp up the aggressor meter. Referee Sujionari gets us underway. 3 3-minute rounds. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, and Cosmo opens up the high lift round kicks, then goes downstairs.
Michael, you were telling me that Alessandro is a tale of two athletes. So it's either one or the other. What did you mean by that?
We've seen Alessandro come and play a point-scoring game in the past where he competes a lot slower. We've seen him come out like a house on fire, all guns blazing. It seems to be the first of the two so far for Cosmo Alessandro. Nice downward elbow there from Elliot Compton, trying to crack the clavicle.
You ever see both where he's able to mix it up into matches or just one or the other?
As the rounds go on, Alessandro has been known to pick up the pace, but can he put his foot down on the pedal tonight here in Manila? Can he find that inner fire? Certainly he's got the experience. Certainly he's got the weapons and a nice ear-lopping elbow there from Alessandro. Knees to the waist from Compton. Spinning back elbow, one of the ones he's known for, the Aussie.
Pick things up a little bit. Elliot goes to the clinch just to slow him down, just a touch.
You can sense the Brazilian is turning up the heat. Compton cannot allow Alessandro to find any rhythm. Jab from the Aussie, goes to the hook. There's the roundhouse kick to the ribs. Alessandro edges forward. Throw the right hand here, goes for the inside leg kick, trying for that federal profundo. There's a crossing elbow from Alessandro. Accidental head clashes. Alessandro led into the clinch there. It's Compton who seems to have taken the foot off the gas a little here on the second round.
He's not as active as he was in the first, and Alessandro seems to be taking the momentum.
Go
ahead. Alessandro smiling. Edges forward again, the tower of power from Brazil. Jab, that's the range finder. Compton may be setting an elbow to charge him with here. Indeed he does, it's a crossing elbow. And they tie up. Knees from Cosmo. Knee guard put on from the Brazilian. And referee Nari Brunson. Half a minute remaining in the second round. A much better round for Cosmo. Lands the uppercut. Gets a knockdown on Compton.
The finish right there again with the uppercut
to the liver.
Cosmo Alessandro.
Championship of the world. Hideki Sekine against Brandon Vera. This fight brought to you by Chunlong Yulur, D88.com. One championship belt at stake. You can see that big height advantage that Vera has immediately.
Yeah, that long reach is going to be very difficult obstacle for Hideki Sekine to try to get close to. But he is a judo black belt. He's a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt. He's got a wealth of grappling experience, so he's got to try to get in there and get one of those legs and drag this fight to the ground.
So far, it's Sekine. Just takes a battering leg to the head, but he continues to circle the perimeter of the cage as Vera stalks him.
Those legs come with such heat and power.
Now he goes downstairs, the outside of Sekine's right leg.
Brandon Vera just stalking forward, looking for these shots. Sekine was almost there, he got close. I don't think Sekine's thrown a strike yet, but he's absorbed a couple of leg kicks. He can't take too many of those, or it's gonna also limit his ability to shoot in and possibly grab that single leg.
Scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. Nobody here at cage side seriously thinks it's gonna go 25 minutes.
He told me he wants to punch his way into a clinch and utilize some of those judo takedowns to get this fight to the ground.
Right hand, knee to the head from Vera. Sekine grabs hold and tries to press Vera up against the cage.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to pressure Vera, stay close to him, eliminate that striking ability, and utilize the takedown.
Tries nice for the clinch. Knee to the head again. Sekine's overhand right missed, and I think he's in a little bit of trouble. Dabs at his right eye. Goes for the single leg, misses it badly. Brandon Vera has an opportunity now, but he backs off. Not wanting to get down there. Right hand straight to Sekine's face, and I think his nose is in a bit of trouble, the Japanese fighter. And the crowd chanting Brandon Vera's name so loudly that I can barely hear myself speak.
Brandon Vera must know that he has a huge advantage on the feet, and he's just waiting to pick his strikes. He's not being too overly aggressive. He knows Sekine is dangerous, and he could clinch up tight and drag the fight to the ground. But Vera's very patient,
he's
waiting to
very
pick his
patient.
Shots.
Yeah, he really is being very patient, Vera. Okay. He's not going to get too excited and jump into a nest of vipers.
Yeah, his nose definitely looks crooked. I think that shot
definitely didn't look like that when he got in the cage. And that's a huge kick to the head. And that nose will be no better off as a result, I can assure you.
Yeah, his nose is going the wrong way. Oh, a body shot, that hurt him.
And he goes upstairs as well. It's gonna be a matter of time now. There's blood from the nose, the punches come down. Yuji Shimada steps in, and Brandon Vera has retained his one championship heavyweight title in front of his home fans at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. Brandon Vera jumps on top, sends in repeated left hands, and really it was just a question of time before Yuji Shimada stepped in.
And still one heavyweight world champion, Brandon the True.
Can't wait for this second round to begin. Crowd really appreciating this. Absolutely packed house here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Very well educated fans. They know this sport well. They've seen many events here at this venue. Loyal supporters to One Championship. Boku comes racing across the cage again. Barely lets Oberall get out of his corner.
I don't think the pace is going to slow down at all from Boku. I would have liked to see the overall corner giving him more constructive critique on what he needs to do, how he can change angles, or really just change the complexity of this fight, because he has to change something immediately to get the fight swinging in his direction.
Huge contrast in the punches being thrown. Boku likes this very snappy, accurate jab. Overall's favoring this big, kind of heavy-looking overhand right that just isn't landing. It's too telegraphed. It comes from too far back. Look at that jab. It's piercing.
Yeah, these shots might not be doing a lot of damage, but they're going to add up over time. We're used to these big power shots from Boku. These big overhand rights, these big hooks. But now he's changed his tactic, and he's dropped
it
with a straight right hand.
head.
Overall is down with his back to the canvas, and now Boku rains the punches down. Overall's head snaps back onto the canvas. He's in some trouble here. His eyes are swelling up and closing. Yuji Shimada is pouncing, ready to pounce. Back onto his feet, but a great left hand from Boku and a knee to the ribcage as well. The crowd going nuts here as the lefts and rights come in.
Body and head,
and Overall's had enough. The variety of the attack there was tremendous.
Right there, what? Boom, right there, the body. Oh, and that was it.
Kotetsu, no face, Boku!
Absolutely delighted for this man because he's always so entertaining. Fights in a way that so many people like to see.
Inside the now sold out Istora Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia. They bound out of their corner. A featherweight matchup. England, the Archangel, and the pretty boy, 1-1-0. Outside low kick from England, and again from England. But wait until 1-1-0 lands the straight right hand. That's his bread and butter combination. I should say, he's brilliant. That's his kimchi combination.
Like that right hand, though, it's slipping right through. It hasn't quite found a home yet, but he's moving quite well. Kwan-Wan-Il is a taekwondo black belt, so he's got a lot of sneaky kicks. He hides it behind all that right hand.
He says he uses the taekwondo footwork to enable him to use his hands, which is very interesting. I haven't heard that before, using taekwondo footwork, which is usually reserved for kicking in taekwondo, being a kicking martial art. But he uses it to slap his hands, and so far, he has knocked out a lot of opponents with that straight right.
Nice takedown defense from Kwan-Wan-Il. I was questioning his takedown defense.
There it is, the big kibosh. It's good night, Irene. That's what he said he'd do. The straight right hand, we called it again.
All you newcomers out there, check out that chin. Bingo, right there on the button. Swarms on him, jumps all over, starts landing some shots. Kim Chang jumps in to stop it. That connected again on the way down.
Amazing elation for the young Korean, the pretty boy. 1-1-0. That was exquisite boxing 101.
Third and final round. It's one championship prelim from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Lee Kai Wen and Emilio Ruzia in a close one.
Final round. Top.
And Ruzia comes forward early, long reach on the jab. Counter right hand there from Lee Kai Wen.
Man, Michael, when I said these were two of the most exciting featherweights in one championship, it was no exaggeration. These two cannot be involved in a boring match.
Overhand right from Lee Kai Wen, but the mustard, the power isn't there as it was earlier. Jab again from Arutia, cuts off the movement. Jab from the American. There's a right hand counter from Lee Kai Wen, drifts back to center cage. These two martial artists have given it their all and some more. You hear the corner of Urrutia saying, walk him down. And that's what Urrutia is doing, continually coming forward. Beautiful jab, uppercut combination from the American.
I like that. He changed it up a little bit, split the guard with the uppercut. But Lee Kai Wen, he's backing up, but he's starting to land as well.
Overhand right from Lee Kai Wen. Oh, momentarily. And Urrutia did the chicken dance. Can Lee Kai Wen capitalize? Yes, he did.
Lee Kai Wen carries that power still deep into the round, into the match. Believes in himself. And look at this. Boom.
Lee Kai Wen.
This man is on a tear. This man is on a demolition mission. Lee Kai Wen of China, 2 weeks ago, a 10-second knockout. This is a real challenge for Shannon Wirichai. We are finally going to see just how good Wirichai is, because you look at the recent opposition. Raju, Yapyaev, Singmina, Formanal, Peter Davis, they don't compare to Shinya Aoki. They're not that caliber. Aoki is the former world champion. He's the best that Wirichai has ever competed against.
Yeah, this is a huge step up for Wirichai in competition. Look at Aoki, closing the gap and immediately goes into the takedown. This is where Shinya's dangerous. It'll be a huge test for Shannon right now. If Shannon can pass this test, it's going to tell us a lot. But watch how Shinya transitions. Oh, immediately takes the back.
This match brought to you by Global Citizen. Some nice popping left hands there from Wirichai. And Aoki takes him down. Top position, half guard.
Beautiful, the way he got that body lock and kept spinning and transitioning, eventually getting Shannon Wirichai down. Now Wirichai's got the lockdown on the half guard here, so he has that leg triangled in between Aoki just to kind of keep him there.
But this is exactly where Aoki wants it to be, inside the opening 40 seconds.
This is his realm. Inside this ground area, it's like a shark in the water. You have no idea where the end will come, but you know it is coming. So if Shannon can get up, it's going to say a lot for Wirichai's improved grappling skills. But Shinya, watch what he's trying to do. Watch how his little intricate moves. All right, look at the pressure of the shoulder on the chin, just so he can pass the guard. All right, look at this. Oh, there goes Mount. Oh, no, this is not good for Wirichai.
You've got to figure the winner here becomes the number one contender for the World Lightweight Championship, held by Martin Nguyen. Full mount here for Shinya Aoki. It spells trouble for Shannon Wirichai.
Wirichai's got to be careful extending those hands. You see how he's reaching his hands up to try to push Aoki away? Watch what Aoki's going to try to do. He's going to try to capture one of these wrists and move him into a bad spot. Man, I spent hours on the mat with Aoki. I know what this feels like. I know the despair that is going through Shannon Wirichai's mind right now. He's got to use, because see how he pulls that arm? Look how he takes that arm and he controls it. He drops an elbow in there.
Oh, elbow between the eyes. He's opened him up. The ground and pound from Aoki has opened up Shannon Wirichai. Here's the aggression. Here's the power. Aoki dropping bombs. Oh, Shannon Wirichai in trouble. It's over.
Shinya Aoki!
Back-to-back wins of the highest order for Shinya Aoki.
Ready? Ready? Fight!
This fight is brought to you by Extra Power Root. Boost your energy. Davis in the red trunks, Pang in the black. Solid left jab from Peter Davis, who's got that wide stance, elbows out very wide, legs far apart.
Yeah, Davis utilizes a very unorthodox striking style, and he kind of has that wide stance. He moves left to right consciously, and you can just see that Adrian Pang just stuck him with a nice easy jab as he came in on him. But Davis is definitely utilizing nice footwork. Adrian's just like, all right, where are you going?
Yeah, where are you going, buddy? I'm right here.
Nice little leg kick by Davis.
Oh, and he just clipped him on the top of the head, which can really ruin your equilibrium. And Davis is in big trouble. And this is going to be over, I think. Yes, it is. It is in double quick time. Adrian Pang has absolutely blasted his way.
Right here.
But he's sitting up, and he's about to... Oh, there it is. That was the really...
That left hand just clips the top of the head, and then four unanswered big shots. There's the left hand that drops Peter, wobbles him a bit, and you can just see those big punches, five big shots landing on the head of Peter Davis for a huge knockout. Adrian Pang, what a big win for Adrian to take a step forward.
Big win. Davis was not defending himself at all there, not able to defend himself.
Adrian Pang!
It really is the old lion versus the young lion. A man who once held the championship against a teenage sensation who wants to be in championship contention. And Christian Lee explodes out of his corner.
I like how Boku waited back. He didn't rush forward. He saw he's waiting. He has that right hand chambered, though, looking for something.
It's that Chudan Suki
That reverse punch, right hand down the center corridor to the solar plexus that Boku throws so well. Lee's showing patience here. Boku's guard very wide, that karate stance of his.
Christian Lee came out in the southpaw stance, took a low leg kick, and immediately switched back to the right. And you can see, he says that earlier that he adjusts his stance depending on his opponent, because he reads things in those first couple minutes to where he needs to be positioned.
Kotetsu Boku really does have what they call ichigeki. One punch.
But he's got to be careful, because Christian Lee packs a good shot too, and with those hands low like that, it's going to leave his chin wide open.
Two athletes renowned for their speed. Shoots in here as Christian Lee, hoping for a takedown. Posts up on the arm, defends as Boku. Can he get up again? Lee tries to slap on a choke from behind.
This is where Lee is the most dangerous. If he scrambles, he can catch you from a lot of weird angles. Now he's got one hook in, now he's gonna try to get the other one. Good defense from Boku to screw his hips out to the side like that.
A big 10-week count for Christian Lee. Six first round finishes for Lee coming in tonight.
Good scramble by Boku to get back up to the standing position. That was clever. He was able to avoid Christian Lee getting the hooks and get back up to his feet.
Seven first round finishes for Kotetsu No Face Boku. Lee presses him against the cage. Boku trying to work the right hand, looking for the undergrip now. And Lee just shrugs him off, drifts back to center cage. Boku sending that right hand again, that very deep and side on karate stance.
That was impressive, the way Boku was able to get back to his feet. He was in a dangerous position. Christian Lee was threatening the back. He was like, oh, he got dropped!
Drills a knee to the head of Boku. The aggression from Christian Lee. Driving knees once more. Boku forced to cover up. No place to go at the moment. Gets back to his feet. And Lee drops him back down.
Oh, Darce setting up. This is with Anaconda. This is when his chokes likes to go for him.
More knees to the forehead there from Christian Lee. Elbow from Lee. And he breaks off. Boku a chance to reset the victory.
We were speaking about Boku's one-punch power, but that was a jab, I think, that did the damage.
The speed of Christian Lee prevailing on that occasion. Boku trying to force the youngster to the outside here. Testing the waters with a roundhouse kick, Christian Lee. Boku threads the jab. Lee resets. Thought about an inside thigh kick. Boku starts very side on. And Lee just wrenches into the canvas. The crowd of power has goodnight, Irene! The teenage sensation pounds out the former champion,
Christian Lee!
Seven first round finishes for 19-year-old sensation Christian Lee. Join the final one championship show of the year. It's Destiny of Champions from the Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur. Debut in one super series of that man, Liam Harrison. The counters in the first round were sublime. The leg kicks superb. Pat Morrow got Willie open up the elbows there from evasion as Harrison leans back like Fat Joe. Good counter again from the Brit. Uppercut to a left hook, the speed from Harrison, the counters off the kick again, he manhandles Pat Morricott. Pat Morricott edges forward, step through knee, aiming for the solar plexus. You can see a little bit more gusto, a little bit more pepper about Pat Morricott. Oh, Harrison almost leaned dangerously into that roundhouse kick. Pat Morricott looked for the elbow, first time in this match.
Good job to Harrison, though. He threw that elbow, and Harrison was already on the other side of him.
That high kick came agonizingly close. Just a little more torque through the hips. Pat Morricott, there's a right hand from Harrison. Toe-to-toe now, the 3-2 from Harrison. Pat Morricott drives the roundhouse kick. Down he goes!
take another look at that. Look at this. It happened so fast. Look at that. Came with the jab with the right, but then over the top
with
the elbow.
What did I tell you? The elbows of Pit Morricot. They do the damage. They slice and dice and fillet. And they knocked out Liam Harrison.
Wow, that one didn't just slice and dice. That one absolutely wrecked shop.
Pit Morricot, Pit Indy.
Pit Indy Academy back in the winner's circle. 2-1 in one super series and takes a knockout winner's medal back to Thailand.